what an absolute beautiful day it is. I went and bought a bouquet of sunflowers yesterday. Check it out. Aren't they just lovely? They're such kind looking flowers to me, which is perfect because today I want to motivate you all to live in kindness. We have talked about love, joy, peace, patience, which are all parts of the fruit of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit helps us live in all of these things, and now we're talking about kindness. On top of getting the kindest flowers ever, I also brought chocolate to share with you all. I ate a lot of the chocolates, but I left you guys these ones. I'm not a big coconut fan.
Sorry to interrupt, Maddie.
Oh, that's okay, Mr. Director Man. Want a chocolate?
Actually, no, I don't like the coconut ones either.
Oh.
I was wondering if it's really actually kind to only leave the chocolates that you think are gross?
Well, I guess I didn't really think about it that way.
Kindness would have also been leaving the chocolates you love the most and offering those to others.
I see what you're saying, because it's practically giving away trash. Because that's how I think of coconuts, really. Just trash fruit. I'm not really sure why God made them, really. They're extremely hard to get into. Like, you need a hammer and chisel just to get into the nasty fruit. And it's not sweet. Have you ever had coconut milk? More like, cocoa, no thank you. And then, why would anyone ruin perfectly good, beautiful chocolate by dipping it in coconut? I'm glad the Holy Spirit doesn't give us the fruit of coconut. Blech. And don't get me started on coconut cream pie.
I think you're getting a little off topic.
Oh, sorry, it's just that coconuts send me...
That's okay. I feel the same way about kumquats. At any rate, a good rule of thumb is to do unto others as you would have them do to you.
That's a good rule of thumb. Who came up with that?
Jesus actually said that.
That makes a lot of sense. He was the kindest person to ever walk the face of the earth. So you're saying if I wouldn't want to be offered only coconut-covered chocolates, then I shouldn't offer coconut-covered chocolates to others?
Unless you know that person really super loves coconut.
Like my mom!
Does your mom love coconuts?
She's cuckoo for coconuts. Like, reverse my dislike for coconuts, and that's how much she loves them.
Well, I guess you know who to give those chocolates to then.
Yes, that'd for sure be the kind thing to do. Hang on, I'll be right back. I just ran and gave my mom those coconut-covered chocolates when she went cuckoo for. Then I ran to the store and bought these chocolates that I'd love to share with you and whoever wants. Here you go.
Ooh, caramel-filled, my favorite.
Mine too. Woo-woo! All right, you guys, I'm gonna find some more people to give these delish non-coconut chocolates to. Woo-woo! Remember to live in kindness. It's the kind thing to do. Woo-woo!
Hey kids, I'm Kyle. How often do you hear people talking about kindness? Do you hear that a lot or never? Why do you think people talk about kindness a lot? Because it's important. Being kind to others is a part of how we show God's love to others. We learned about the fruit of the Spirit, love, in the first part of this series, Motivated. Loving God and loving others. We talked about how we show others that we love them through our actions. And part of showing love to others is being kind. You know, being kind is not always easy. It would be so much easier if I could just be grumpy and yell at others when I'm upset. But I have the Holy Spirit in my life, so I work on being kind to everyone. I love to share with others or be generous, and I love to help others. Those are ways that I can be kind to others. And kindness is one of the best ways to show God's love to others. So today, we're learning, I am motivated to live in kindness. Let's all say that together. I am motivated to live in kindness. Do you know who has the most kindness? Jesus. He loves us so much and he was willing to forgive us of all the bad things we do. All we have to do is say, I'm sorry, and Jesus forgives us. That's very kind. You know, there's a Bible story about a man named Boaz. That's a funny name. And how he was kind to a lady named Ruth. So let's read it together. We can find this in the Old Testament in Ruth chapter 2. And remember, this is a true story from the Bible, which means it really happened. Ruth was the daughter of Naomi. One day, Ruth asked Naomi if she could go into the fields and gather grains that were not picked up so they could make food out of them. Ruth went out to gather grains behind the harvesters, and as it happened, she found herself working in a field that belonged to Boaz. Boaz went over and said to Ruth, "Listen, my daughter, stay right here with us when you gather grain. Don't go to any other fields. Stay right behind the young woman working in my field. See which part of the field they are harvesting and then follow them. I have warned the young men not to treat you roughly. And when you are thirsty, help yourself to the water they have drawn from the well." Ruth fell at his feet and thanked him warmly. "What have I done to deserve such kindness?" she asked. "I'm only a foreigner." Did you hear that word she said? Kindness. Boaz was being kind to Ruth. He was letting her pick grains that were not being taken by other people. That's very kind because Ruth didn't have another way to get these grains. Let's keep reading. Listen for when Boaz is kind again. At mealtime, Boaz called to her, "Come over here and help yourself to some food. You can dip your bread in the sour wine." So she sat with his harvesters, and Boaz gave her some roasted grain to eat. She ate all she wanted and still had some left over. How was Boaz kind to her this time? He let her come eat food with him and all the other workers. That's really kind because she didn't have a packed lunch or there wasn't a cafeteria or any food around. Boaz even told his workers to drop some more food in the fields for Ruth when they went back to work. He noticed that Ruth needed some help, so he was willing to help her and be kind to her. Let's keep reading. When Ruth went back to work again, Boaz ordered his young men, "Let her gather grain right among the sheaves without stopping her, and pull out some heads of barley from the bundles and drop them on purpose for her. Let her pick them up, and don't give her a hard time." So Ruth gathered barley there all day, and when she beat out the grain that evening, it filled an entire basket. She carried it back into town and showed it to her mother-in-law. Ruth also gave her the roasted grain that was left over from her meal. How was Ruth kind to Naomi? She gave her the leftovers from her lunch, and she shared with her all the grains that she had picked up. So Boaz was kind to Ruth, and he even let her keep working in the field all the way through the summer. That's a long time. Okay, let's keep reading. So Ruth worked alongside the woman in Boaz's field and gathered grains with them until the end of the barley harvest. Then she continued working with them through the wheat harvest in early summer. I am motivated to live in kindness. Let's all say that together, everyone. I am motivated to live in kindness. When we're kind to others, we're showing them God's love. And guess what? We can be kind to everyone. How can we be kind? We can share our snack with someone who doesn't have a snack. Or maybe your friend is sad. You can give them a big hug. We can help clean up after dinner time and help our parents. There are so many different ways that we can be kind. You know, being kind can be kind of hard when people are mean to us. But the Holy Spirit helps us to be kind. So when we're having a hard time being kind, we can say, "Holy Spirit, help me be kind." So I want you to think of the people in your life that need kindness. You can be a good example and show kindness to them. If you continue to be kind to others, they will see that you are different. And that's a good thing. We can understand that people have bad days and we can show them kindness. You know, it might even make their day better. I am motivated to live in kindness. Let's all say that together, everyone. I am motivated to live in kindness. And maybe you want to start being motivated to live in kindness, and you want to take the first step in your relationship with God. You want to start your friendship for the first time. You can do that today. You can do that right now with me. So just pray and ask Him into your heart. Dear Heavenly Father, we love you. Thank you for everything that you have done for us. Thank you for dying on the cross for our sins. Lord, we want you to be the leader of our lives. So come into our heart and change us. We want to feel your love, and we want to practice kindness to those around us each and every day. Amen. If you made the decision to make Jesus the leader of your life, tell a leader, tell somebody around you. Don't forget to be motivated to live in kindness. And when you have those moments where you don't want to be kind or you see someone need some kindness, practice being kind. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you have kindness.
Hey, I'm Christy. Kindness is a really big deal. I want you to turn to the person next to you and tell them one way that you've been kind to someone in the last week. Being kind to everybody is not always easy, but guess who can help us? The Holy Spirit. So when we're having a hard time being kind, we can say, Holy Spirit, help me be kind. And maybe in some situations, the best way to be kind is to tell the person who's bugging you, hey, I need a minute to chill so that I can make sure I'm being kind to you, and then politely go take a breather. Kindness is part of how we can show God's love to others. And it shows God love too, just like memorizing verses. Let's practice our memory verse. Galatians 5, 22 through 23. But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Let's all say, I am motivated to live in kindness. Ready? I am motivated to live in kindness.